If you've ever wondered what is GEDmatch, well, GEDmatch or GEDmatch or GEDmatch is an open data personal genomics database and a genealogy website that's based in Lake Worth, Florida. That's based in the US if you didn't know that. Now, GEDmatch started becoming really popular after April 2018 because it was used by law enforcement to identify suspects in the Golden State Killer case in California, but more on that later. Now, the aim of GEDmatch has always been to help amateur and professional genealogists and researchers, but also to help adoptees to find their biological parents. GEDmatch was started by just two guys back in 2010, really with absolutely no full-time staff, just volunteer work, and they stated in 2018 that they've helped over 10,000 adoptees to find their biological parents. That's no little feat. Now, why would you upload your DNA to GEDmatch? Well, the main reason why you would upload your DNA to GEDmatch is to compare your own DNA to the DNA of other people around the world that might not have used the database, might not have used the analysis service that you have used. And what I mean by that is that, let's say you've used Ancestry.com to analyze your genes and you've identified several family members around the world. Now, that's great. But what if even more family members have used another platform, let's say 23andMe, but you can't see them on Ancestry.com because they didn't use your same platform? And this is quite unfortunate, and this is where GEDmatch comes in. GEDmatch solves this problem of having to rely on single platforms to find your family members by having a common database that can compare your DNA to the DNA of people that have used absolutely any database in the world. And GEDmatch has a feature that's called a one-to-one comparison, where you can compare your genes directly to the genes of someone else and get an analysis report that's usually based in centimorgans or cm. Now, that's an ambiguous unit for most people, but there's an easy way to convert those centimorgans to a percentage basis if you use a table. And after you've identified a percentage of match of your genes with someone else, then you can easily identify whether that person is, let's say, a parent, if they've got around 50% of a gene match, or they might be a grandparent with, let's say, 25%, or that could be an aunt or an uncle with also 25%. If someone comes with a gene match of, let's say, 37.5% or something around that, then they might be a sibling of yours, a brother or sister that you've not known your whole life. So that's really how GEDmatch can be useful for absolutely anyone who's looking for more information about where their relatives are around the world. And GEDmatch will also provide you the email address if that person has added it to their database. Most people actually have added their email addresses to the GEDmatch database, and you can contact them directly without having to rely on 23andMe, Ancestry.com, and the other databases, which people might not be using on a common basis. You can instead just directly email them. Let me now go through just how easy it is to set up your own GEDmatch profile, and I'll also go through some of the most useful features that you can see on your webpage after you upload your DNA analytics. Now, of course, if you do want to get any useful features running on GEDmatch.com, then you do need to upload your DNA analysis. I think that goes without saying, pretty obvious. So once you've logged in for the first time, it's going to show you all of these terms and conditions and the privacy policy. And one thing to note here is the fact that GEDmatch is now operated by a company called Verigen Inc. Now, Verigen is a company that acquired GEDmatch some time ago. But anyway, if you're okay with that, then you can accept these conditions. So that will clearly take you to the homepage, and the homepage might not be as display friendly as you've noticed with other websites, especially 23andMe, which is quite visual. You've got pictures everywhere. On this website, it's just text. So you have to know what you're doing. Now, if you're uploading a 23andMe profile, then quite obviously you can go to upload your DNA files and click on generic uploads, 23andMe. So if you click on that, it will take you to this page, and then you can upload the file that you have downloaded from 23andMe or Ancestry.com or whatever DNA analysis company that you've used. Now, after you've uploaded it, just hit the upload button and it will take you to a page that will look like this. This is a profile that I've already set up, and I've already uploaded my DNA analysis reports from 23andMe, and I've not made it available to the police. And really, that's all it takes to upload your DNA information from a website like 23andMe onto GEDmatch.com. So once you've done that, you can use these features like one-to-many on the side. Now, one-to-many is a feature that allows you to compare your DNA with the DNA of everyone around the world. What you might find even more interesting is the one-to-many DNA comparison results, where you just enter your kit number and it will show you with whom your DNA matches from everyone who uses GEDmatch.com around the world. Now, something to note here is that you might notice that it will report everyone's email addresses as well, so you can actually directly contact those people instead of having to rely on GEDmatch.com to talk to them. Now, another very useful feature that I found is the admixture or heritage. And if you select the project, and as you can see from this website, they've clearly mentioned what each of these criteria does, and whatever you select will compare your genes to that database. So for example, if you're definitely from South Asia and you want to look at where specifically does your DNA match with compared to other South Asians, then you can select Harappa world or Harappa world. And as you can see, it will compare your DNA to the results of this project. So every project may be slightly different and may not be completely accurate, but each project will have their own specialities. So you will have projects that do specialize in European genes, in European heritages, and they might be more accurate at identifying your heritage if you are European. And I selected this one because I'm South Asian, of course. And as it says, I'm the closest to this Gujarati A population, which is, well, correct, because I am Gujarati. And just to show you what happens if I selected the MDLP project, which is, it does mention it's for Europeans, but let's go with it anyway. And in this case, it says that I'm 62% Asian. And once again, I'm gonna select another project called Eurogenes and compare my DNA to that one. Under Eurogenes, it thinks that I am 66% South Asian, I'm 23% West Asian, and apparently I'm 5% Baltic. I don't know how it's derived that, but yeah, it just means that when they compared your DNA to the genes in that database, they found that 5% of your genes matched with European genes, for example, Baltic genes or whatever they say. So I noticed that all of the databases gave me very different results, and I really don't know what to make of it. If you're planning on performing a serious crime, but you have a GEDmatch account, then I would seriously advise against it. Okay, I would advise against it even if you didn't have a GEDmatch account. But the reason is because the FBI has routinely uploaded samples of criminal suspects' DNA onto GEDmatch to identify whether they were present at a given crime scene or not. Now, these crime scene DNAs are usually available with the police after a crime has taken place and the police has performed its investigation. And the FBI has routinely taken the DNA samples or the DNA samples of the families of criminal suspects and compared them to the DNA that was present at the crime scene. And it's easy to identify whether that person was present on that location or not. Now, with the Golden State Killer case, the police were a bit more strategic about how they were dealing with things. And they collected the sample from the kit that was preserved from the criminal scene back in Ventura County. And they took this kit, they sequenced the DNA, they uploaded it to GEDmatch, and they identified about 10 to 20 family members of the criminal suspect, the criminal that had actually committed the crime. And what they did is they employed a genealogist to identify who that person might be that is related to these 10 to 20 people. The police went to the house of that person and collected some DNA samples out of allegedly that person's trash and sequenced the DNA, uploaded it to GEDmatch, and it was a definite match. And this is how the Golden State Killer criminal was caught. Now, of course, this is quite an extreme situation and it's a serious crime. Of course, this person did need to go behind bars, but there are certain other cases where you might not want your DNA available to the FBI, let's say, or even the police or any other government authority. And GEDmatch does allow everyone who uses the platform to opt out of their DNA data being available to police officers, and you can also make your DNA information not even available to public, where you can just look at other people who have made their DNA publicly available, but you don't have to. If you like this episode, then make sure you hit the like button, but more importantly, do make sure you hit the subscribe button, because that's an important one. That will make sure that you come back when I have created even better content. So if you've hit the like button and the subscribe button, then I hope you have a lovely day. See you next time. Bye.